In this video, we will learn how to set up analog input-output on IS7. Analog voltage and current inputs through the drive control terminals can be used for various commands, such as setting the drive frequency and torque commands, as well as feedback when controlling PID function. However, depending on the load system, the minimum and maximum value of commands or feedback may vary. For example, when 0 volts is entered, drive stops at 0 Hz, and when 10 volts is entered, drive runs at the maximum frequency. It is normal operation. In some cases, you might want to stop drive until 2 volts is entered, or you might want to drive at the maximum frequency when only 8 volts is entered. In this case, you must set the frequency for the analog input. The analog output is the same. The multifunctional analog output terminals, such as the A01 and A02 terminals, allow drive operation information, such as output frequency and output current, to be converted to voltage or current. You can also resize the actual output voltage or current according to the output value. Next, we will learn how to set the analog input-output range. First, let's learn how to set the target frequency with the analog 0 to plus 10 volts input. The analog input related terminals are VR plus, VR minus, V1, I1, and 5G. VR plus terminal is 0 to 10 volts output terminal. VR minus terminal is 0 to minus 10 volts. And V1 terminal is analog voltage input terminals. I1 is analog current input terminal, and 5G is for common terminal of analog input. When entering output voltage of external device, you wire the V1 and 5G terminals, or I1 and 5G terminals properly to drive's terminals as mentioned above. When using drive's internal power source, you can wire a potential meter of 1K to 5K ohm to VR plus, V1, and 5G. Parameters related to analog input can be set in in-group. First, set in-group 6 to unipolar because we do not use the negative voltage now. If you want to use minus 10 volts to plus 10 volts, you can set bipolar. You can set the time constant of filter for analog voltage inputs in in-group 7. Parameters in group 8 to 11 allow you to set the range of input voltage. You can set the minimum input voltage and the corresponding frequency, and maximum input voltage and corresponding frequency. The frequency corresponding to 100% of the analog input can be set in parameter in group 1. Next, we will learn how to set analog input related parameters using the IS7 keypad. In this video, we'll set the drive to run 0 Hz at 2 volts, 60 Hz at 9.5 volts. First, press the mode key to enter parameter mode. Set to FX-RX1 at DRV6 and set to V1 at 7 before moving to in-group using the direction key. Set the minimum input voltage at in-group 8 to 2 volts and the corresponding input level to 0% at in-group 9. Set the maximum input voltage at in-group 10 to 9.5 volts and set the corresponding input level to 100% at in-group 11. Next, we will learn about setting up analog outputs between 0 and 10 volts. Analog output terminals are A01, A02, and 5G terminals. A01 is the analog voltage output terminal from 0 to 10 volts. A02 is the analog current output terminal from 0 to 20 milliamps. And 5G is the analog input and output common terminal. To output voltage to the voltmeter, you can connect the two terminals A01 and 5G. Parameters for analog outputs can be set in the outgroup. The A01 and A02 terminals are the multifunction output terminals. Therefore, you can select an output item for A01 directly in parameter outgroup 1. You can select the output item from the driving frequency shown on the screen to the fixed values like output. In this video, we will select the frequency at 0. In outgroup 2, set the gain value for the analog output. And set the bias value for the analog output in outgroup 3. Gain and bias are reflected in the output as shown on the on-screen formula. Next, we will learn how to use the keypad to monitor the current frequency through the output of 2 to 10 volts. In this video, we will set the output to 2 volts at 0 Hz and 10 volts at 60 Hz. First, press the mode key to enter parameter mode. Use the directions keys to move to the outgroup. Select 0 frequency in A01 mode. Set the gain value for analog output to 80% in outgroup 2 A01 gain. And bias value for analog output to 20% in outgroup 3 A01 bias. The frequency at 100% input can be set in in-group 1 parameter. It does not always work with the maximum frequency, so be sure to check it. If you want to set the maximum frequency to 100 Hz and drive at 100 Hz when the analog input voltage is at its maximum, you must change the in-group 1 parameter to the same value. If the analog signal contains noise components, set V1 filter high. Next, let's run the test under the parameter conditions set above. Wire the potential meter using internal power source to the VR+, V1, and 5G terminals. Then rotate the potential meter and verify that the target frequency changes. Below 2 volts, the frequency command will be 0 Hz. At 8 volts and above, the frequency command is 60 Hz. We'll do an analog output test next time. Because bias is set to 20% and gain is set to 80%, the graph is drawn according to the output frequency as shown on the screen. Now, we have learned how to adjust analog input and output on IS7.